welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. I look crazy today. It's been forever since I have filmed a sit down video, but we took our little puppy out today. We went to TJ Maxx and PetSmart, and I thought I would show you guys what I got from these places. Full disclosure, I did not go in only for puppy and dog things, but this haul is mostly dog stuff, and there is a lot, as you can tell by the bags and bed behind me. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. I find these thank you cards, and they had a few packs of these. This was $5.99. I use thank you cards a lot because I sell my used clothing and accessories on Poshmark, and I like to put a little card in there. And also when I do a giveaway, I like to send one of these to the winner, and these are just super cute. I also got a gold phone charger. It is only 3 foot. I was thinking that was gonna be really long, but I wanted another gold one because we got one similar to this recently. So I picked this up. I might return it, I'm not sure. I also found two packs of Ray Dunn journals. In this pack, we have one that says Explore and we have one that says Write. And I really like these because of the cute pictures on them. I love this globe picture. Then the other pack says Create and Dream. And it's not like I necessarily needed these, but I am a stationery and notebook junkie, so when I saw them, I pretty much had to get them. I also found a lot of great clothing items at TJ Maxx, but I'm gonna do a completely separate haul video for that so that I can try it on for you guys and you can see how they fit. So stay tuned for that, but I did find 4 or 5 shirts and I found a pair of pants. So that's like a win. I never really find that much clothing at TJ Maxx. On to the dog stuff. So Cooper, for anyone who doesn't know, is a Labradoodle and an Aussie Doodle mix, and he's gonna be 50 or 60 pounds when he's bigger. And right now he is outside a lot, and then he starts smelling bad. It's been raining like crazy here in Kentucky, so he's been wet a lot when he comes in. So I was really excited to find some of these microfiber towels. These are supposed to absorb better and be more comfortable. So I got 2 of these. I got a blue one and a white one with cream on it. And they're really cute, and it just keeps us from using our regular towels for that. I also found this toothbrushing kit, and the toothpaste in here is peanut butter flavored. And I had already bought a children's toothbrush that I'd been using with him, but since he's a puppy, I was just getting him used to the idea of it, so I didn't actually have any toothpaste yet. And this comes with a finger brush and a regular toothbrush and the toothpaste in there. And it's in this little pack, so in case we ever go somewhere, we can take it along with us or put some of his other stuff in here. So I thought I would pick this up, and I'm excited to test it out with him. So Cooper doesn't know it yet. He's watching me as I'm filming this video, but he got 1 million treats today. I'm always looking for healthy treats for him, like the soft training treats. And since he's still teething really bad right now, we want to keep him from being destructive as much as possible. So I was specifically looking for harder treats today that are good for that. So I did find these puppy teething rings, and these have super clean ingredients. This is something that I've never seen before, but they are grain free. They're supposed to help soothe their gums when they're chewing on them. And this is a whole new bag. This is blueberry and barbecue flavored. Not sure that's a combo that I would have put together, but I'm sure he will love it. I also picked these treats up from PetSmart today, and he already ate one on the way home, and he loved it. I think he knows what I have right now. TJ Maxx also had some Zuma Chews. I have never heard of these before, but apparently it's like a toy and a bone, so you can throw it like a frisbee, and it is 100% edible. There are a bunch of them in here, and it was only $5. And lastly, for treats, I got him some of the quad treats. You can pretty much always find these at TJ Maxx and Marshall's. They're not super expensive, but again, they have really clean ingredients. Plus, they're really cool looking. It's kind of like a toy for them. So we got some mini ones and we got two big ones, and one of them is pumpkin flavored, but these are peanut butter. He hasn't tried these yet, but our last dog really liked them, so I'm hoping he likes them as well. So far, we haven't really found anything he doesn't like. Then, of course, I bought him a bunch of toys because I just can't stop buying him things. I hate to see the day I have a child. Since he's teething, he's been kind of tearing up all of his toys. So we are buying a lot to make sure he always has them. I'm hoping he's eventually gonna stop tearing up his toys, but who knows? So I try to look for tougher ones. This one is from Planet Play. It's a little bunny rabbit, which is cute because Easter's coming up. And it's kind of firm here, and then it has a little rope for the tail. So there is that dog toy. And I found this adorable lamb. I know he's probably gonna destroy this in no time, but it has the crinkle paper. Also got him one of these. It is shaped like a lobster. It's super cute. But the fabric is much thicker and it's fleece, and apparently the way it's sewn together is supposed to help it stay together. You can tell it's like a tougher one. So I'm gonna give this to him today and let him chew on it, and hopefully he won't destroy it, at least for a week or a few days. When we were at PetSmart, I found this toy, which Cooper's really excited about it. It is from Top Paw, and it was $15. Not sure I really want to spend that on dog toys a lot, but if it's something that's going to last longer, then I will. It is a cow, and it's leather up here, and it has these hooves on it. Yeah, so it's a fancy toy. I'm sure he's going to have fun with this one, and that should help with his chewing also. Last thing from TJ Maxx, this is Cooper's third dog bed. He grew out of the first one. He tore the stitching on the second one, and here we are. This was really the only one that's the right size for him right now, and the fabric is waterproof. He hasn't had any accidents in his crate so far, but I went ahead and got this one, and it's good for that, just in case it happens. So this is the perfect size for him, and the print's really cute. It kind of matches the couch, so we got him a dog bed. At PetSmart, they had this super cute leather collar, and it is the cutest collar I've ever seen. It is a size large, so it's a little big for him right now, but he's gonna keep growing, so we went ahead and got it. It was the last one they had. Also picked up a Furminator, which is a de-shedding tool for anybody who doesn't know. He has been shedding like crazy, and we have heard really good things about this. I'm excited to use this when we're able, and hopefully that will help us out with some of the shedding. He is also growing out of his harness, so we got him this one from the Kong brand, and it's really heavy duty. It has like a vinyl rubbery part in the middle here that's really strong. It matches his olive collar, and I just love the color green. He looks so cute in it. So we went ahead and got him this, and hopefully this will last us for a little while. Last but not least, it is a gold border bronze one, and it is so cute. So we have his name on it, and then on the back we have our phone number and stuff like that. So that is all I have for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed this haul. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below. I hope you join our little family here. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.